So after intensively research on what is leadership, I stumbled upon this story about a clock builder versus a time teller. So once upon a time, you met a remarkable person who are able, imagine you're able to, the person able to see the sun and the stars and able to read the exact date and time using the stick, you know, the to read the time. Yeah. So, but however, how do you imagine instead of meeting this guy who able to like read in the stars to able for you to tell the time, but you can meet a person who able to build a clock, who able to really make a clock and tell the time forever, until he passed away, the clock is still there. So what I'm going to say is, time tellers in the world, there's a lot of time tellers who masquerade themselves as a visionary leader who have a lot of ideas. But however, you imagine this is a time teller, a really small eclipse lead. And what time teller does, they actually tell the time. So you imagine like, other than telling the time, they said about, oh, I can do this. They ask to do projects, or they can really ask you to do stuff. But however, what time teller does is just telling. So imagine how you take out the time teller of the equation and it just drop off. So everything the time teller does is just telling. So imagine if you are a clock builder instead. Clock builder is a really big chocolate box where is the base is really white. And they inspire people to do stuff and they inspire people to really set their goals. So what they really leave behind is actually legacy. Yes. So a real clock builder leaves behind legacy. So legacy is what really makes a great leader. So moving on, and I want to type like every one of you guys can be a leader. It's just a basic. What is the definition of a leader? The definition of a leader is you just lead a group of team. But in the world there's a different types of leadership. However, due to 5 minutes or 7 minutes talking time, I'm only like going to explain to you about 3 types of leaders: autocratic, transactional, and lastly, charismatic leadership. So we're moving on to autocratic. Autocratic is where a leader has a plan and they want their plan to go their way. So for example, alright, I'm the leader right now and I'm going to say this is what is my plan. Don't talk bad about me, don't raise your voice about me. This is my plan, it's going to work and that is what I'm going to do. So what is autocratic leader is that they really want their way and no one really and the followers don't dare to talk back. So if they talk back, they know what they're going to get. So for example, what is autocratic leadership is all about? You imagine Kim Jong-un in North Korea. Yeah, that is the super perfect example of autocratic. So what example, like Kim Jong-un say, I want my followers to attack South Korea. Or I want my army to attack South Korea. The army don't say, hey, I don't want to attack South Korea, I want to repart at my bum chilling. Yeah. They cannot answer back. If not, they will just cut off. Yeah. So that is what autocratic leadership meant. It's where there's a leader and they didn't listen to any inputs the follower had. So next, we had transactional leadership. So transactional leadership is where normally a manager and a subordinate. The manager say, okay, I have a task for you and you need to do. And the subordinate say, okay, I can do it. But what's the difference between transactional and autocratic is transactional, if you perform well, you get a bonus or a gift for positive reinforcement. Or if you do it bad, you will get fired or you will be cornered out and won't do anything as such. So that is what auto-transactional leaders are. Is where you form a contract between the leaders and the followers, where you make where you do a specific task and you have a contract. Whether if the followers do that specific task correctly, will be rewarded. If not, will get punishment. Lastly, charismatic leadership. This leadership is my favorite because it's the only type of leadership where you need to use your charm and your personality to influence people, not the external source. Like for example, I've been granted as a president by outside. But for charismatic leaders, it's their charm and their personality inside that makes them a leader. So I break down charismatic into two types: attention and image. So attention, a charismatic leader will pay attention to you and listen to you and talk to you and feels like you are the only person in the room. Yeah, so that is what charismatic leaders are all about. And next is image. Image is where they give a very persuasive type of vibe. And the way they talk, the way they speak up, they always use metaphoric and philosophical ideas to reach out to your followers. So that is the types of leadership that I want to share. But for me, personally, as a leader, it's not because you can do the stuff or you can able to lead. It's for me, is no matter how much money you make as a leader or how many achievements you make as a leader, at the end of the day, is either you are the time teller or the cop leader. Thank you very much.